Welcome back, programmers. In the today's section, we are gonna learn about variables. Now, variable is the same concept for all programming languages. Like if you know Python, C, C++, Java, all programming language, same concept of variable. Like if I type a equal to 10, so a is variable and 10 is the value which I stored in a. Means variable stored a data, like. And here you can see I type a comment in here, JavaScript code start here. So how you can write a comment and what does it means? So comment is a comments for our program. Like if I say a equal to 10, so I write comment here, comment a is a integer. So this is comment. It doesn't gonna affect on our code in here. And this is a single line comment. But what if you need a comment for a multiple line? And for that we have a multiple line comments. For that we just need to do is slash star and comments. This is our comments and end the comment like here. So this is our single line comment. So that's how you can write a single line comments and multiple line comments. So let's just remove this and this also. Okay, so now let's move on. So variables, first I'm gonna write a document. And if you don't know what is document.write, what is HTML, so watch out my previous video. So I'm gonna write here in h1 tag and in the center tag variables, and I'm gonna close h1 and I'm gonna close center. So save the file and open it in browser. You can see when I gonna reload this, you can see we got a variables. Okay, from now we are gonna make a variable in here, but first I need a HR line in here so it look good. You can see when I reload this page, we got a line in here. Okay, let's make a variable. Okay, in JavaScript, if we want to make a variable, first we need to decide what we want to do, declaration or initialization. Let's say I want to store an integer value, so the keyword is where a equal to 10. So this is the declaration of variable a, and this is integer where b equal to let's say I want to write a string in here, so I'm gonna write all in one code. So this is string. You don't need to specify the character string or integer in JavaScript. So let's say variable c equal to true. Now if you don't know what is boolean, so watch out my previous Python series, because Python is a signature language of mine, and Python is a very huge packages and modules and so many good things. Python is a volcano of programming. But let's move on JavaScript. In a simple way, boolean character return a true or false. Okay, so let's add a comment line in here. So this is an integer, and we don't need to specify integer character string. Okay, if you don't know what is integer, what is character, integer is a numeric value, string is a characteristic value, but array of character. And if you don't know what is array, check out my C++ video. Okay, this is a string and this is a boolean. Okay, spelling is wrong, boolean. Okay, so integer, string and boolean. Okay, and there is another two, like where d equal to 10.99. So this is a float value, float decimal value you can say. This is a float value, you can see after a dot numeric value, and there is a long two like variable e equal to 99.99999. So this is a long, or you can say double. So there is so many data types available, but this is our main data type: integer, float and string. Okay, so we just declared our variable in here. You can see we just declared our variables. Now how we are gonna use this variable, and for that we are gonna do simply, let's just print the variables, and for that I'm gonna use document.write. okay, in here just enter the variable name like a. okay, so that's how you can use your variable. Okay, and I'm gonna copy it and I'm gonna paste all the a, b, c, d and e, all the variable. Okay, so let's just say b, c, d and c and d and e. Okay, so save the file and open the Chrome and refresh the page, and you can see we got 10, we got all in one code, we got true, we got 10.99999999 10.99 and 99.99, but all these things in a single line. Okay, that's how you can use all variable. Let's remove all this stuff, and that's how you can use your variable. And if you don't want to use where, and if you don't initialize direct variable, so for that just where a, this is good, and a equal to 10, and document dot write a. So that's how you can initialize, use and print our variable. So let's reload our page, and you can see we got 10 in here. Okay, you don't need to specify a value in here, you can also specify the value in here. Let's say what if we have same name variable. Okay, which variable is are gonna print, so let's just try save and reload. You can see we still got 10 because in here first a value is 20, and then we initialize our variable and we change the value of a is 10, so that's why a printed 10. Okay programmers, that is it for today. I know I told you in the today section we are gonna learn CSS, but believe me, CSS is important, but we are gonna see in the features video. In the next video we are gonna learn about operators. So thank you for today's guys. If you learn something, like, share, subscribe and comment for more videos. Thank you.